morning class, my name's Haley Eagleman, and my speech is on mental health for the homeless. The question is, why are homeless people different from others that they can't receive mental health support as well? The mental health of young people with experiences in homelessness, breaking the cycle, evidence-based aversions for homeless individuals with mental illness, attitudes towards homeless people, beliefs, and burnout among NHS staff and physical and mental health work settings, and perceived discrimination, coping options, and the relationship to mental health and psychological distress in homeless adults. Just to mention, I didn't want, like a little disclaimer, I didn't really want any homeless pictures on my PowerPoint, so I just settled with what they had offered for the template. So, breaking the cycle, evidence-based diversion for the homeless individuals of mental illness. The resources and infrastructure in place to serve our nation's homes for homeless is spread thin. Attitudes towards homeless people, beliefs, and burnout among NHS staff in physical and mental health work settings. The second chapter of this research aimed to explore factors that contribute to stigmatizing attitudes in staff working across mental health and physical health settings. Maintain repeat homelessness via interacting pathways of social isolation and maladaptive coping, such as substance use, gambling, or antisocial behavior. Perceived discrimination, coping options, and their relationship to mental health and psychological distress in homeless adults, and seeking to address this issue, the present research uses a social identity approach to consider the relationship between homelessness and mental health, focusing on the roles of perceived discrimination, social identity, social support, and coping options. The current research finds that homeless people do perceive discrimination and this associated with negative psychological outcomes. These findings highlight the negative association between homelessness and mental health via social identity-related processes that, unlike others, stigmatize minorities. Oh, jeez. I missed a part. For the attitudes towards homeless people and beliefs and burnout among NHS staff and physical and mental health work settings, 66 health professionals were recruited from a range of the NHS settings and were required to complete an online survey exploring demographic factors, psychological factors such as attitudes, burnouts, evaluated beliefs, effective working with complex clients, stress and support, and professional factors, training and experience. T-tests revealed that significant differences between staff with mental health experience compared to physical health staff, such as physical health staff, showed more stigmatizing attitudes towards homeless clients, lower effective working with complex clients, higher levels of depersonalization, and poorer perceived levels of support. All of it's mixed up, I'm so sorry, but thank you for listening.